And listen, I'll tell you what though, a full bookshelf is dope. A full bookshelf is cool. It's nothing like that Instagram ready, aesthetically pleasing bookshelf that screams, I'm educated and I ain't scared to let you know about it. And I wish I had some in my background right now, but my bookshelf is all the way to the left from just my kitchen right now. But I'll tell you what, a lot of books sometimes just collect dust on the bookshelf. And in this video, I will share with you five platforms that will help you sell your used books so you can make some money. We're all about that in this channel. My name is Reflex. If you're into that, please subscribe. Let's get into it. Let's do it. We're not wasting no time. Now, of course, the big boy, the one that is obvious, is Amazon. Amazon, Uncle Jeff Bezos. I wish he was my actual uncle, but that's all cool. Amazon, man, it's, you know, the biggest out there when it comes to books, started as a book platform, but it's a little bit more complicated than you think when it comes to selling your books on there. So let's break it down. So in order to sell on Amazon, you need to set up an Amazon seller account. And what you need for an Amazon seller's account is a business and contact address, a telephone number, preferably a business telephone number, a chargeable credit card, and identity. It could be your passport, it could be your driver's license. Now, you'll be asked where you want to sell your books, where you want to sell your products, and Amazon sells in a host of different countries, United States, United Kingdom, Japan, all across the world. So you'll be asked where you want to sell your products. If it's exclusively United States, you note that in your Amazon seller account. And there's two types of seller accounts that you want to consider when signing up for one. Let's look at two real quick. Number one is a fulfilled by the seller account, where you pretty much, you pack it in your house, you pack your books in your house, and you fulfill the order and you ship it to the person who purchases the book. That's the fulfilled by the seller account. Number two is a fulfilled by Amazon account, where you take the books, you take the orders, and you collect them, you take it to an Amazon approved warehouse or Amazon site. And when people order, the people at Amazon warehouses, they fulfill your orders, they pack it and they send it off to the people who purchase. So fulfilled by Amazon and fulfilled by seller account. So consider that when thinking about signing up for a seller account on Amazon. Now, of course, the fulfilled by seller account or the fulfilled by seller method is gonna be a little bit more challenging for you. It's gonna be a little bit more work for you because you actually put in the work, gotta put in the work and make the bread. And in considering what kind of route you wanna take, there's something you gotta consider, and it's how much it actually costs for you to sell books on Amazon. And there's two things to consider. Number one is the individual plan. Individual plan, it costs 99 cents a month. And in order for you to be considered for the individual plan, or you thinking about signing up for the individual plan, think about if you are going to sell 40 books or less. If you're gonna sell 40 books or less a month, then the individual plan is good for you. It costs only 99 cents if you wanna sign up for that. The other plan is a professional plan. It costs $40 a month, $39.99 a month. And it's for people who will sell more than 40 books a month. So the individual plan, 99 cents a month if you're gonna sell 40 or less books a month. A professional plan, $39.99 if you're gonna sell 40 or more books a month. Now let's talk about a referral fee, which is gonna trip a lot of people up. Now, Amazon sellers pay the company a referral fee, which is a percentage of all the total price. And it includes the item price, the shipping cost, and any gift wrappings that is associated with that item or that book that you're selling. For a book, the referral fee is 15% in addition to a $1.80 closing fee, which you pay in addition to the selling price or the selling fee. So that's something to consider, the selling fee when looking to sell books on Amazon. Now there's other fees associated with your account, the kind of account that you create, whether it's a fulfilled by the seller or fulfilled by Amazon account. So I'm gonna put it up on the screen right here and you can take a look. And first we're gonna consider the fulfilled by Amazon. Your monthly fee for storing your goods on Amazon fulfilled by the seller depends on how much inventory you are selling and how long the products are sitting on their shelves and their warehouse. So in addition to that, you're also responsible for a fee associated with packing and shipping your item to the warehouse. So if you're looking to do the fulfilled by Amazon account, I would strongly consider you go on Amazon, you click right here, and you look at the fulfilled by Amazon fee and consider that. And also it's the same, you click in the same place and consider the fulfilled by seller account. You have to pay your own shipping costs up front. But Amazon is also gonna charge you for shipping fees based on the product's category and shipping method. So that's something you wanna consider for sure. And for books, the shipping fee could be anything from $3.99 for domestic, you know, standard shipping to $46.50 if you wanna ship it internationally. So that's something to consider when it comes to fees and selling on Amazon. So I know it's a giant out there, but you know, they're pretty, their hands go deep in the pockets You know, so that's why we tackling it first up front and getting it out of the way. You feel me? Now, when it comes to Amazon, there's other fees included. So I would strongly suggest you go on Amazon's seller account, or you know, just Google Amazon seller account and you know, read through it, see what other fees they will levy on you. But here is what you need to know when considering selling your books on Amazon. Here's what you need to know: choose your plan wisely. Choose it wisely. Look at it, read the fine print, and consider if you want to do a fulfilled by Amazon account or fulfilled by seller method. Either way will work for you depending on how you want to do it. So consider your plan and choose it wisely. Secondly, follow Amazon seller guidelines. Experienced users and experienced sellers on Amazon say you want to follow their guidelines strictly. I have a bunch of books on Amazon, I have 3 books on Amazon. You definitely want to follow their guidelines strictly because they will kick you out the joint and you won't be able to sell on Amazon anymore. So follow their guidelines so you stay in line and you continue to make money on the platform. It's a giant platform, which is thousands of countries around the world. So follow the guidelines so you're gonna be straight. Third thing to consider is this: be honest. You know what I mean? If you say your book is new and somebody gets it and it doesn't have a book jacket and it's wrinkled and it's just beat up, you got sticky notes like mine, and people are gonna leave a bad review, and that's just gonna hurt your business. So be honest. Your book is in mint condition, or your book is wrinkled in the front, or just be honest, and people are gonna respect it. People are gonna buy it. I want to read that book so bad. If you got a copy that is, you know, a little bit jacked up for a price that I like, I'm gonna buy it from you. So just be honest up front. And last but not least, the things you need to know before selling on Amazon is consider your price. Consider your price. Don't go put a used book on there for $14. You know, just consider your price. I know there's fees associated with it, but be honest. Put your price in, you know, in a reasonable way that you can make at least $3, $4, $5 every sale. So those are the things you need to know for selling on Amazon. We're gonna move on to the next, and it's this. All right, so at number two, we got Abe Books, A-B-E Books. And Abe Books is really a marketplace for used books, fine arts, and collectibles. And on Abe Books, sellers are required to hold their own inventory, ship their own stuff, create their own listings. In fact, you do everything yourself. Kind of like the Amazon sellers account where you fulfill it yourself. So it's a little bit more work involved with Abe Books. But here's what you need to know on how to sell on Abe Books. Here's the breakdown. So on Abe Books, you have to decide if you want to use a professional account or if you just want to sell a few items, a few books using the website's book buy back section. And here's how it works. To do that, you have to choose a partner website to work with. You have two choices: Zifit or Textbook Rush. And the latter, of course, is if you're selling textbooks. But if you're using Zifit, which is a mobile app, you just download a mobile app on your phone, and then you just type the barcode of your book that you're selling. You just type the barcode into the app. Once you tap the barcode into the app, it's gonna pop up with an offer amount for your book. And if you're happy with it, you accept. Somebody's gonna collect the book and you ship it off and you get the money. I have in my hand Stay With Me by Ayobami Adebayo. Incredible book. Just finished reading this again. So if I type the barcode and it comes up with, you know, $2.99, I can accept that. But I have to have at least $15 worth of sales to be able to fill that batch order. So I can't accept that $2.99 right then and there. I gotta put more books to reach that $15 threshold before I can actually start shipping them out, or before the website or the app will allow me to fulfill my batch order. So you gotta reach at least a $15 minimum to be able to fulfill on Abe Books. Now on Abe Books also, you need to meet some requirements. First, the book has to have an ISBN number. You gotta have an ISBN number, that's important. The book also have to have its supplements. If it's a book that has CDs, you gotta have the original CDs in the book, or they will not accept that. The book also have to come with everything, you know, with a book jacket. If the book has a book jacket like this one, it has to come with a book jacket. You cannot sell it just like this. So gotta have the jacket with a book, you know, and everything that a book had in its originality, you gotta have it with a book or they will not accept it. The book also cannot have any annotations, no writings in it. So this one, for example, if you can see, I have some, you know, notes, sticky notes. So I gotta take all of those out if I wanna sell it on eBooks. Cannot have any annotations on there. So it's a little bit more stricter, but that's another platform in which you can sell your used books. To sell on eBooks, much like Amazon, you gotta have an account, and it costs $25 to have a basic account on eBooks. So you pay a minimum fee of $25, you create your account, it's a plus account, and you got your account on eBooks, you can begin selling books on there. But of course, if you wanna use the website's book buyback option, it's much cheaper. You can just go on there, sell one or two books if you want, and just make quick cash that way. Or use the Zifit app, and make quick cash that way as well. Now the cool thing is you don't need to purchase tracking with 8 books. Every purchase that you make or you fulfill using the ZFIT or book buyback option, it comes with a free tracking. So you just go on FedEx, UPS, whatever, send out the book and people can track it with a free tracking that comes with the option. So that's 8 books. We're gonna move on to number 3. And now we got Etsy, the beloved Etsy. You already use Etsy to shop for cute handmade stuff. Did you know you can shop for books or sell books on Etsy as well? Like every other platform, you would need to create an account. You can use your Facebook account, you can use your Gmail account. It's easy. You just sign up, you create an account, and here's how to sell books on Etsy. Simple stuff. You'll be guided when you create your account through the process of selling on Etsy, on how to create a name for your shop, the currency you'll be accepting, what kind of cash you'll be accepting, US dollars, pounds, euros, all that kind of great stuff, you know what I'm saying, shishi, money, and what items you'll be selling on your platform, in this case books. Now you also need to handle shipping. You can choose to make your shipping on Etsy free, or you can choose to make the seller pay for it. So consider those accurately. Now if you choose to pay for it as a seller, Etsy can either calculate it for you, or you choose how much you want to charge for shipping. Now of course you can include that in the handling fee when you packaging and shipping your book, and include that in the price of the book, and buyers can pay for it if they want to or not, depending on how much you put on it. Now, how much does it cost? How much does it cost as a seller to sell your books on Etsy? Great question. Let's get into it. First, there is a listing fee. You will be charged 20 cents for every listing you put on Etsy, and every listing lasts for 4 months. Every listing lasts for 4 months while the item is being sold. So 20 cents for every listing, every book you put up, you will be charged 20 cents for every listing, every book that you put up to sell. There's also a transaction fee, which is 5%. So every item that is sold, there is a transaction fee, which is 5%, which will be charged. And that includes the shipping and handling as well. So everything included, you will be charged 5% on that. So if everything included is $10, 5% is gonna go to Etsy. So consider that transaction fee. Also, there is advertising and promotion fees on Etsy. If you choose to advertise your stuff, if you choose to promote your stuff using Etsy's platform, here's a listing of how much they charge for transaction and promotion. So consider that as well. And it's optional. You don't have to do this. It's optional. But consider this. Go on the website and check it out if you want to promote your stuff. And get more eyeballs. Get more buyers. And also, there is shipping fee. Much like every platform, there's a shipping fee which Etsy offers to you. And it also depends on domestic, you know, shipping, international shipping. So all of that you can find on Etsy's website. But those are some things you need to consider while selling your book on Etsy, which is an amazing platform, by the way. So next we have Declutter. It's an app much like 8Books where you use to sell used books, and it's some key differences though from 8Books, and we're gonna look into that real quick. So much like 8Books, you go on the Declutter website or you download the app and you click on the sell CDs, DVDs or books tab. Then you scan the barcode or you enter the barcode and you wait. You wait to see how much the book is gonna be offered. So much like 8Books, it can be offered $2.99, $3.99, $4.99, $5.99. You just scan the barcode and you wait, see how much the offer is going to be. Now here's where it gets a little bit more complicated to fulfill your order, as Declutter calls it, fulfilling the order. Once your book is offered, you wait. You wait until your badge is up to $5. So it's not as bad as 8Books where you gotta reach 15 bucks, but on Declutter, you gotta reach 5 bucks before you can actually fulfill the order, complete the order and ship it out. So once you hit $5 mark, then you can fulfill or complete the order and ship it out. They give you a UPS shipping label, you print it out, you put it in a box, and you drop it off at the customer site, the UPS customer site, and you're done. Money in your pocket, book off. Now, how much does it cost to sell books on Declutter? It's one of the cheapest. It's free, including shipping. You don't gotta pay jack nothing. You go on the website, you download the app, you package the book all for free, and you just send it off. Nothing attached, no fees, no nothing. It's the cheapest. It's free on Declutter. Now Declutter, the only way to make money on there is to sell more books. So dig deep, dig in your shelf. The books that got the most dust, that's what you wanna dust off and sell. You sell more books on Declutter, that's how you make more money. And it's cheap, free. Just gotta meet $5 threshold and you ship off the books and you're good. So this next and final one is one that a lot of you might be familiar with. I just got on the phone with my sister. She's trying to sell some earbuds. I referred her to this site, and it's Letgo. Letgo. I speak about Letgo in other videos, but with Letgo, it's much like eBay, how you sell stuff on eBay. So with Letgo, you just sign up, and it's free to sign up, and you create an account. You create an account on Letgo, you categorize your book. Now on Letgo, they don't have a book category, so you gotta put your book under other to sell it. You put a photo of your book, just drag a nice taken photo of your book, you put it on there, you create a listing, add a description, and you wait. You go watch a movie, you wait for somebody to click buy, purchase. You don't have to meet a threshold. You don't have to do anything extra. You just put it up there. You can wait 2 weeks, 2 days, 5 hours, 5 weeks. It don't matter. You just wait until somebody wants to buy the book on Letgo and you let it go. So how much does it cost to sell on Letgo? Well, it depends. Letgo doesn't really charge all that nominal fee, transaction fee, all that other stuff. It's much like Facebook Market. They don't charge much. You sign up for free. Everything is free, 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 free. That's what I like. Free. Free in America. Don't really exist. But it's different because you actually meet your customer. When somebody clicks, I want to buy this, it got to be in your area, and you meet with that person, then you give me the money. Here's your book. So it's different in that sense. They're not transacting. You're not shipping anything. You're not, nothing is being processed, no warehouse, no nothing. So Letgo is another option if you're into that. Letgo.com. So what you need to know before selling on Letgo is being able to be organized and on your own terms. So, you know, you control everything. You are the boss on Letgo. Set notifications so people hit you up, you see the notifications. You know, make things private. Meet at, you know, public places, supermarkets, you know, malls, and protect your privacy as much as possible because there are scammers out there on Letgo. So consider that. So those are some quick sites, platforms where you can sell your used books on, make some quick cash. That's what I'm all about on this channel. My name is Reflex. If you enjoy that, hit the subscribe button. Leave a comment below. I want to know if you've used some of this platform before, if you know of any that I didn't mention in this video. I would love to hear of those. And yeah, man, get those books off the bookshelf that are collecting dust. Let them go, man. Other people want to read it and they're interested to buy at a low price. So make some extra cash in that way. I will see you on the next one. Appreciate y'all for watching this to the end. Peace.